Hi there. I just wanted to do a reading because we've been talking about, that I've been saying a lot of people are going to have dreams, mainly masculine energy. And if you followed me from last year, this is what I felt was going to happen is the way that the final, whatever it is, before union, they would dream something. And there's been some plot twists. Recently, and especially for me, I feel very differently about the twin flame thing. Back in the day, we were kind of thought to believe it could be just one particular person. And throughout time, what many of us are finding is that that one person we thought it was turned out to be a false twin and turned out to be the person that really taught us everything we knew about self-love. They were our greatest teacher. Now the counterparts coming in, right? Which I've been channeling the news coming in. And for some of you, the new coming in is still crumbs and fuckery. And for some, the new coming in is this counterpart. Could be the actual twin, right? The soulmate, whatever it is, however you want to word that. Now, I talked about it last night that there would be dreams happening. Well, lo and behold, last night I had a dream and I wanted to share this with you guys. I also got channeled the songs, and it's two of them because they have the same title, Dream Lover. Now, you guys are very familiar with Dream Lover by Mariah Carey, but there is also a very old school song called Dream Lover by, I believe his name is Bobby Darin. And if you guys want, go listen to both of those songs. That's the energy that I'm getting, coming to me now, is that they're having premonitions. You're having premonitions. Things are happening in our dream state, whether it's sleeping, daydreaming, meditation. It's all starting to fall into place. I wanted to share with you the dream that I had. I already have a very good idea of who it is that's coming into me. He's a real person. He's not just someone that I go, oh, he just is a tall person with dark skin, dark hair. This person really does exist. We haven't technically met just yet, but the dream is, and it's not the first time I've dreamt of him. The dream last night was we were like hanging out together, and it was, I guess, his apartment. It didn't look like a house, and I don't even know if he has a house or an apartment. Because I believe he has several. besides that, I'm pretty sure we were in his apartment, and it was kind of like a first date sort of a thing. And he was making me something, and I can't remember what he was making. I can't remember if he was making food like dinner. I can't remember if he was making me something like a project or something, but he was working very diligently on something. And I remember I just was kind of hanging out there, kind of talking with him, waiting, and he was just really busy doing something, making something, either food or I don't know. Maybe they didn't even show me what it was he was making. That's why I don't remember. I don't know. I just know that I kind of hung out with him, and it was a very, it was flirtatious, but it was still very friendly. And I just found that very interesting. And there could be many symbols within that dream for myself, which I know what they are, even though I'm not a dream interpreter. I know what they are. And it's kind of like for some of you, this person that's going to be coming in, they're working on themselves, really. I mean, it's the most obvious thing. They're working on themselves, getting ready for you, vice versa. Okay. I thought it was an amazing dream. I mean, I dream of him sometimes, But then, sometimes you don't, and especially for myself personally, you guys know I don't focus on love. I don't. I'm very happy being single. I feel free and I don't feel lonely. And I'm, really busy with my career and what I do for a living. And I'm really busy with my clients and, I'm busy building my empire. And I wasn't ready for love, and I don't think I'm still quite there yet. And this other person's not quite there yet either. But are we gonna meet when we're both ready? I don't know. That's for the universe to kind of decide upon when they feel our paths are meant to cross. Anyways, let's just go ahead and shuffle. So dreams are just going to be off the hook. And dream lover. Having premonitions. For some of you guys might know the person, some of you might not. For some, you might dream and you go, I don't know who the hell this is. Even for them too, they might dream and not know. For me, luckily, I know who they are. The Tower is a very first card too. This is Uranus. This is Mars. Remember, Uranus entered Mars on November 6th. Expect the unexpected. Towers are going to be coming down because they're meant to. Because old structures need to come down in order to make way and make space to build the new. You and this person are going to be building a new structure together. Therefore, the old structures in your life or their life have to come down. And the universe will make sure that that happens. Some of them might be in relationships right now. You might be in a relationship right now. But it's one of those things where you knew it was over for quite some time. It's unstable. It's not a good foundation. That's why the universe is intervening here. And these two people, see, it's a couple. These two people are falling from the tower. A couple. For those that are in relationships, that's not going to be the case very much longer. And that's divine intervention for those that decided to stay longer than they should have. The tower energy cannot be avoided because major arcanas are universe energy. Can't free will that motherfucker. You can try and delay it and push it around, but honey, you can run and you can't hide, I can assure you. Six of Swords here is moving on to calmer waters. So there's going to be this rocky period of time, right, when the destruction happens, however it ends up happening. And then when the dust settles, peace of mind. Because I think it happened suddenly. Now, this doesn't just have to be endings that occur here. This can be, boom, an epiphany. Right? The dream, a premonition. Psychic insight, things of that sort, remembering past lives. This can just be boom, instant recognition, boom, remembering something, light bulb goes off. This can also be sudden endings, but sudden new beginnings. Someone comes in out of left field. You don't see it coming, and I keep channeling that. For some reason, you or the other person don't see it coming. Maybe it's because of the element of surprise. To be surprised, you can't see it coming. Right? You can't. Because some people will try and control it. Some people will go, no, not that person. No, it's not. It shouldn't happen like that. Well, let me go and see if I know better than the universe. You have the Seven of Cups. Seven of Cups can be about options, confusion, dreams, illusions. I told you it's dreams. Something, the dream state, right? Downloads. It's premonitions. It's like the universe is giving you clues. Maybe your angel guides, spirit guides, I don't know. It's like they're giving you and them clues. So it's almost like all these little tiny pieces to a puzzle. Then some have figured out already, like myself, because honey, I am FBI, honey. I am the head bitch in charge, okay, when it comes to any type of investigative shit. My psychic insight's wide open. So for me, I figured out who it was very quickly. And also, it's because I know that person. First detective on the scene, basically, for myself. And for some of you, same thing. And then for some, no matter how you try and figure it out, the universe goes, not time. Because I think you figure it out and it's revealed, like I was saying in, you know, that reading that I did, it's revealed when it's time. And it's just not time yet for some of you. Although, man, I can tell you something right now, the ball is starting to roll. Things are just starting to pick up. Memories are happening too. Very nostalgic. Because something about the energy feels like they could be remembering past lives and so could you. It's nostalgia. Very past life shit. Like very Six of Cups. And then for some people, there's an extreme leap of faith here that needs to happen. Because you see here, we do have the Fool. But what happens when the tower comes down? The tower destroys everything. And then now what? It's a fresh, clean slate. You can't write it. The universe gifting both of you with a fresh start, clean slate, new beginnings. It's your reset button. Zero. Full circle. have here the Devil, the King of Cups, and Cancer, Chariot. Devil could be Capricorn. So Capricorn, Cancer, King of Cups, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. Water. This is the thing. Low vibrationally, a King of Cups type of an energy, male or female, is a person who feels a lot of emotions but won't say it. They almost keep it to themselves as leverage too, in a sense, is what I feel. Especially with this Devil card right next to it. Devil cards, low vibrations, could be mindless manipulations, could be addictions, could be fucking codependencies. Anything of that sort falls into this, right? Devil card really is restrictions. And in this particular spread right here, this is restrictions. This person feels a lot. They don't say nothing. This is what I feel. Because with the Chariot here is moving forward, progress. For some of you, that Tower energy and the Six of Swords moving on to something else is, and this is going to be for a few of you, I don't know how many, moving away from someone that wasn't giving you what you deserve. They were holding back emotions. And it's like that's what the Tower comes in and blows up. Maybe you have, I don't know, some of you still in that relationship, some of you not in it, but still haven't quite let it go. I don't know. But I can tell you, this is restriction. Someone here is holding back emotions and feelings. That's one scenario, okay, that I feel. Now, the other scenario is going to be that this person comes in lightning quickly, okay, the new person, the high vibe counterpart. They come in out of fucking left field, too. They come in quick and hot. And it's like, it's so much energy and feelings and shit. It's like trying to be suppressed because they can't make sense of it now with the Seven of Cups energy. It's like confusing. It's nothing like they've ever felt before. There's two scenarios here. One where there's some kind of a low vibration here that this person that you were fucking with or still fucking with purposely withheld their emotions. And then you have this situation where they don't mean to, but it catches them off guard and therefore they don't know what they're feeling or what to do at first. They know that they feel extreme sexual attraction here too. It's extreme. It's carnal. It's almost obsessive. This is the thing. When you meet this new person, this actual counterpart, not just any old Tom, Dick, or Mary new person, the one, the counterpart, it's quite obsessive energy almost. They literally become obsessed with you in a good way though. And that's what scares them is I don't think they've ever quite been so obsessed with anyone like that in their life. Could be you too. Could be mutual energy, right? Two obsessed people with each other, which would be ideal for me. I do like a good obsessed motherfucker. But someone that I'm in love with, not just a random fucking stranger. Not no single white female kind of characters, you know, like the movie. This is obsession. This is someone that's going to be so fucking consumed. It's insane. And I think at first when they meet you, they know. They go, I've never felt like this about anybody in my entire life. And they're so afraid of allowing themselves to feel everything because they know once they do, that's it. See how these two people are chained? It's like hook, line, and sinker. They know it too. But they, you, like I said, you can run, but you can't hide. Victory. Moving forward so victoriously too. You can run, you can't hide. And I'm not saying that they're going to run and hide from the energy, but meaning like inside they may go like, fuck, what the fuck is this? If I succumb to this, well, what if I lose myself? But this is the thing, because you're going to be with a high vibrational person, you're not going to lose yourself. You guys have the perfect balance. You guys know better, you know? And here we have the Ace of Pentacles, the big guns. This is them offering you everything. This is starting from scratch and building a very, very stable foundation. For some of you, this can be moving, career change. This can also be money coming in. But this, for me, symbolizes the universe gifting you something solid. They come in offering stability. It's not a rocky foundation like that old structure there. This is going to be solid gold, is what I feel. Solid gold. Like, they've literally never felt anything like it in their life, like, ever. You have the Five of Pentacles and the Four of Swords. Five of Pentacles is feeling left out in the cold or ghosted. And then you have the Four of Swords here, which can be healing. It's also surrender. Someone here is healing from this energy. Five of Pentacles. Either they had to leave somebody or they got left. it's almost like because there was tremendous healing that had to happen there for you or them or both of you, make somebody hesitant, y'all. That's how come when they feel this energy of, I could be so in love, I'll be obsessed and never be able to ever let you go, kind of hesitation. Because they remember what that felt like before and it didn't quite work out. You do or they did. Could be both. Something didn't happen very well here and something ended and someone had to walk away or they felt ghosted or was ghosted. And then the healing came from that. But that's the thing here, though, is that if it's the right person, there is no more ghosting. You're the one. Ace of Cups flew out. My cup runneth over. This is self-love. I am love. So my clients absolutely love my I Am Love bracelets because of the power that they feel when they wear it. When you master the art of self-love and you don't seek validation from anyone and you're happy being single because you feel free and not lonely, the counterpart appears. And not only that, you would mirror each other because your energy is connected from all of these past lives. What you do reflects on them. We know that. It's the mirror effect. So they call it twins, right? That's what the twin flame thing was about. But I think people have a different misconception about what the twin flame is. And who knows who's right or wrong because there's no scientific proof. But this is what I think. I think there was a misconception about what it was. Self-love is the key to everything. It's the key to all abundance and miracles. It's the Holy Grail. This would be the Holy Grail. And the premonitions are going to start coming in hot. There it is. Two of Cups. I told you, connected, mirrored, equals, counterparts. You have a full cup. You attract them in because they have a full cup. Right now, though, I feel like there's a bit of this healing that has to happen because the structure is coming down for most people, which means this energy is going to be very relevant. And who knows, even if they may not be in love with the current person they're with or you, it doesn't mean that it doesn't hurt you to leave a situation because, you know, it is something that, you know, takes time and healing. Three of Cups. So there was three for some of you, right? Structure gets taken down, tower energy. Now there's two. So for some, it is a third party situation. But for most of you, you've never met the person yet. So technically, it's not third party. But from three people in this equation, it will come down to two. Decisions will be made. I'm telling you right now, when you meet this person, whether you guys are completely ready or not, I can assure you, you be in the same vicinity as them, they catch sight of you, you catch sight of them, you hear the voice, they hear the voice, you guys, whatever, okay? It will be unmistakable. There it is. Look at that. The fucking lovers. Sacred. Sacred lovers coming together. Old sacred union. Blessed union. Protected union. Bound. The counterpart appears. This is also a decision in love. This can be Gemini energy also. But there is a decision here that was supposed to have been made a very long time ago. And it wasn't. Now the tower comes in. Tower comes in to course correct and also clean house. So the true counterpart can appear. See the angel up there with the sun? Something's activated. The truth comes out about something. Clarity. It's also divinely guided and orchestrated. Like I said, you can run, but you cannot hide. You get into the vicinity of this person, and they get into the vicinity of you. I'm telling you right now, it's a done fucking deal. Done. Done deal. You know, dream lover, come rescue me. That's Mariah Carey's song. I want to sing it right now because, you know, my voice is kind of atrocious at the moment. And I'm not the best singer. But like I said, you guys go on YouTube after this. Go look up Dream Lover by Bobby Darin and Dream Lover by Mariah Carey, hunty. They are absolutely having some type of insight, whether it's psychic, whether it's daydreams, whether it's dreams, actual dreams. It's the universe is going, it's time. Put it this way. It's like, you know when a movie's going to come out or show and they start showing you previews of this movie or this show? that's what's happening right now for you and them. There are previews being shown right now. Kind of prepare you. Get you excited about it. Previews. Amazing, right? Dream big. Let go of small thoughts about yourself and see yourself succeeding. Notice that word dream in there too, huh? Not by coincidence. Waves of prosperity. New abundance and exciting opportunities wash over you now. It sure is time, isn't it? Look what's on the bottom of the deck. The soulmate relationship card. New romance with a spiritual basis is here for you now. And, you know, I always tell you guys that when I see those swirls, it reminds me of the DNA strands, yeah, the double helix. And that is just so important because something is going to happen chemically wise, okay? So when we get the Temperance card with alchemy and shit, it's more spot on than we really know. Something happens chemically to us. And not only that, it's really about you and that other person coming together to create a child for those that are, you know, straight couples. Those that are able to have children, because some just are straight couples, but they can't have children. Now, how does it work for the same-sex couples? I don't know. I haven't been channeled that. What I know is that for people that are coming together that I'm channeling for here, not all of you, because some are going to choose not to have children, but, or can't have children, or, you know, whatever, same-sex. Well, I'm going to tell you something right now. Whatever's meant to be is meant to be, so I don't want you to get upset on that fact of, oh, my God, what if I can't have children? What's meant to be is meant to be, right? You guys know this. Those that are meant to have children, you and this person's DNA is going to be swirled together and combined. That's what I feel like this is. There's some type of chemical reaction when you guys both meet. And then from there, the two souls, the two DNAs come together to create this little star child, basically. This rainbow child. This is meant to be. Like I said in the other reading, and I believe it was the Vision of Love reading, it's going to be so beautiful. All of your ancestors are going to come and watch this union. All of your ancestors are trying to push this union together. After the healing of the old ancestral wounds, now everything's at peace. It's time. They can finally help. And they will help if you let them. If you let them. We want to go ahead and get some Isis Oracle cards out. I was mentioning to you guys how crazy it is that there's so many cards in this deck, but every time I grab cards from it, the same cards keep coming out over and over and over. And that's not by accident, right? We know that the energies are going to be so strong. You're going to get the same ones over and over and over if it's meant to happen, right? The same cards. Goddess Isis, what messages do you have for us today? What can you tell us about this person coming in? Or about us? What messages do we need to know? What do we need to know? What's important? What do we need to know? Flower of Life again. You are entering a fertile period of your life. You are guided to think of yourself as a creative being and to surrender your control over how things will manifest and instead allow them to do so. Don't resist change. Instead, go with the flow and let it happen. Now is the time for your blossoming. Absolutely gorgeous. You are coming into your own. You flourish and things around you just, it's like you become a magnet. Everything starts with self, though. And this is really harvest time. Here we go. Dreams are coming true. So, for example, for those of you that wished on stars, wished on planets, wished on starfish, like my bracelet, put intentions out there, you prayed, those things are starting to manifest. You have to allow it to come to you, though, okay? You have to Surrender, because everything comes to you via the path of least resistance. That's why for most people, things come to us when we're not expecting it and when we're not looking for it. That's when it comes. Look at this, Eye of Horus again. I pulled this on my live on Instagram, xi_missy_xi, a few days ago, and here it is again. The Eye of Horus brings divine perception, protection, and insight. You are gifted with certain spiritual abilities, including divine sight, that are awakening and growing now. You have much divine support and protection so that you may grow your abilities and serve others with your divine gifts. Trust your perception and know that you are divinely protected. I was channeling that word protected also recently. And not only that, the psychic insight, and told you guys, it's all coming together. That's how come they're getting this like major insight, whether it's dreams or just psychic hits about it. And so are you. Because for these people that I'm channeling for, it's a very elite group of people, as you probably have figured out. They have certain gifts, and when they come together, they have a mission. Yes, it's just like the twin flame thing that we've always been told. But there are little variations to it, okay? Eye of Horus. If you guys have ever seen the movies Now You See Me, they're excellent movies, right? The other night, my cousin, we were at my grandma's house. She just so happened to put it on TV, not knowing, right, that, oh my God, if I would have had to choose what was on TV, that's what I would have wanted to watch, what I would have wanted to have watched. And in the movie, it talks about the Fool card also, and here we have the Fool card, right? The Fool card is the most powerful card in the deck because it provides you with a fresh, clean slate. You can become anything you want to be. Who are you? What do you want to do? Is this who you are? This person? This old version of yourself? Or do you want to recreate this new version of yourself? And it's like almost like you don't even have a choice. It's almost like when it's meant to be, you're guided. And the universe will see it fit to make these things happen so that your old structure comes down, the old skin gets shed, and you become this new version of yourself. The two of you will come together and help to change the world is the point. How beautiful. They're dreaming of you. You're dreaming of them. Surrender to it. I do that. Just because I see a face and a name doesn't mean that I'm going to put all my stock into it being that person. I don't do that. I still say to the universe, bring my counterpart, whoever he may be. Whoever he is, bring it. I'm not going to be stuck on a specific outcome because that's not me allowing the path to be not resistant, right? It's always the path of least resistance. And so I'm just saying, okay, universe, bring whoever's meant. Even though I have a goddamn good idea who it is, I'm not going to focus on that because I've learned that lesson and I know how energy works. I'm going to be the best version of myself, and I know that the person that I'm meant to be with, I'm going to attract that same energy to me. I mean, he's going to be a fucking godly-like person, I can assure you. Time. You are trying too hard. Give it time. That's just not a smack in some of our faces. As you guys know, for me, I have an issue with time, which is why they always push me to be patient. It's one of my biggest lessons is to be patient and to allow and not control. To surrender and allow was one of the hardest things I ever had to learn, but I learned it. Do I have to keep myself in check 24/7 about it? Sure. Time is an illusion, right? I'm real stuck on time periods. People who know me, they know this about me. I'm very stuck on that. I want to know when. In the sense of months, weeks, January, February, when. But time is an illusion. It really is. And I know better. But yet still, that petty 3D part of me and the impatient part of me wants to know when. See how it says you are trying too hard? Because some of you have to take your hands off of it and let it go. Give it time. Surrender to it. Allow it. member now via the path of least resistance. That's why I won't get stuck on a particular outcome or a particular person. I won't do it. I'm not going to try to control it. I'm going to allow what's meant for me to come to me. And trust me, if you're meant to be with this person, nothing's going to stop this union. Nothing. They're dreaming of you. You're dreaming of them. You're getting these previews, premonitions of the person and what's to come. Now, don't forget that just because you meet a person doesn't mean it's this energy. Sometimes the universe is not done testing you, and sometimes it's not even tests. Sometimes your energy is still low and you didn't learn the lesson. You're attracting the same fuckery back into your life. Not that it's tests. Some, yeah, it's a test. And for some, you're attracting the shit back into your life. Still stuck on the hamster wheel. Haven't learned the karmic lessons. It's coming because it's time. The truth is going to be revealed, but it will be revealed in divine timing. I know, I hate that word. Words, divine timing. Because divine timing usually for me means slow as fuck. And you know, when I get ridiculous, I'd be all like, oh, divine timing. So what does that mean? What, this lifetime or next? Like, but then I know better. I know that what's meant to be is meant to be. Shit, I know this. I teach this to my clients. But, you know, sometimes I get caught up in that. And that's why I always have to check myself and say, no, divine timing with who it's meant to be with and how it's meant to be. We're not going to stay focused on that outcome. So if you were to ask me, Missy, do you think it's that person that you're dreaming of, that you have this insight on? Do you think that's your person? My instincts and my intuition says yes, he is the person. But still, I want to let go of the outcome. And just let it come to me. And it will, if it's meant to be. It will. Four cards. Let's see if I feel it. Love yourself first. Self-respect makes you more romantically attractive. No, this is self-love. The Ace of Cups energy. I am love. For those that want to order my I Am Love bracelets, they're back in stock again, finally. You know, click on the links below. All of my info is there if you want to order some of my products. My Wish Upon a Starfish bracelets have been doing such a phenomenal job. So as I keep saying, for those that have purchased my bracelets, please leave comments below and let people know how you like them. You have a full cup, you attract someone with a full cup. Stay optimistic about your love life. Positive thinking and faith will bring you romance. Abso-fucking-lutely. Stay on this high vibe, positive vibe. We are not lonely. We are free. Honey, I'm enjoying myself right now being single because I know this is coming to me very quickly. And I'm not quite ready yet to kind of, you know, give up what I have with this lifestyle. It's not that I do shit. I don't do anything. I stay at home and I do nothing. So it's not like I'm a party girl out there partying every fucking Friday and Saturday night. It's not it at all. I stay home every fucking weekend. But what I'm saying is I enjoy doing that by my damn self. You know what I'm saying? So, and when you become, you know, into a coupleship, a relationship, those things change, you know, and I just kind of enjoy my alone and quiet time right now of reflection. And it's been a really long time for me. I was in a very long-term, not very great relationship for 11 years. And after that, I had, you know, two relationships after that, which didn't work out. And I'm just enjoying the shit out of being single right now. I'm optimistic about it. Don't get me wrong. I'm not going to push it away if it comes. But at the same time, I'm very much still enjoying my single freedom. You have honeymoon. Sorry, that was my hair. Honeymoon. Enjoy the bliss of holiday time together. And then romantic feelings. Your feelings are real and worth exploring. There's that full moon again. If you watch that other reading I did, I talked about how the full moon just kept making itself known to me. But this is release. The honeymoon card for me has kind of always been about letting something go, because they're in a gondola moving on to something. It's very Six of Swords energy, and you have the Six of Swords card here too. This reminds me of that same energy, moving on to calmer waters. Even though it says honeymoon, I know, but it's what I've always been channeled about that card. And then romantic feelings, pretty self-fucking explanatory. This is going to be magnetic. The chemistry between the two of you, off the charts. People will be able to just feel that electricity between the two of you. Literally, you guys walking down the street or just sitting there talking or looking at each other, all eyes will turn to look at you guys because the energy will be so strong. It's going to be insane. You ever heard that saying, you know, God, with Mercury retrograde, you know I can't even communicate it to. God damn it. It's that thing where they see, it's like on Instagram too, I've seen it recently, where they talk about, I want that type of love where they say, damn, do you see the way he looks at her? It's something of that sort. And I apologize. Sometimes in Mercury retrograde, I'm tongue-tied and I literally cannot communicate what I'm thinking. But it's that, damn, look at the way he looks at her. That's the kind of love it's going to be, where people are going to watch the two of you and see the way he looks at you, and you look at him, or you look at her and he or she looks at you, or whatever it is. And it's going to be like, wow. Wow. Look at the way they look at each other. And not only that, the two of you guys are just going to be like peanut butter and jelly, honey. Okay? You guys will not want to leave each other's side. But there will be this distance that will have to come. Whether it's because I feel the travel thing's huge. So either you guys live not close, you guys meet while traveling, or something to do with travel, someone's job might be very much so with a lot of traveling. I don't know the details on that because it's going to be very different for everyone. But you know, there's going to be some type of distance here, but you guys will still be in an actual relationship. It's not ghosted. You know, it's not an old person that ghosted you and, oh, that's the distance. We're together in the 5D though. No, I'm not fucking talking about that. Honey, this is about the 3D world. You guys are going to be together in the 3D world, but just in a long distance relationship, or in a relationship living together, but just a lot of travel involved somehow. All right, guys, this is that channeled message about dream lover and the dreams that are coming in. And again, I wanted to share that dream with you guys, with me. And I thought it was very profound and very interesting that I dreamt that he was like really happy and, you know, excited to make something for me. And I remember I just kept saying, let me see it. You want me to help you? You want me to help you? He just kept saying, no, no, let me do this for you. I got this. No, 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 I got this. And it was the most endearing thing I've ever seen, really. And I know it was just a dream, but it was amazing. And it's so symbolic on the fact that, you know, he's getting ready. He's working on himself, but he's also working on his gifts. We have gifts, they have gifts. I don't know, it's weird. They're working on their gifts. They're getting fine-tuned. He's gonna come in and he's gonna be godly like, that's why. And is he godly like right now? Sort of. Yeah, yes and no. He's gonna come in and just literally be godly like. Reminder, I'm going to be coming to NYC next month, to Brooklyn in particular. If you'd like to purchase tickets to my event, please click on the link below. All of my info is there. If you want to purchase my bracelets, hunties, click on the links. Don't forget my friend Kyoki from Aloha Elixir. He is going to have a huge sale for Black Friday weekend and Cyber Monday. But you have to sign up for his mailing list, alohaelixir.com, and then he will email you a discount code. My I Am Love candle, which has been out of stock all this time, will be coming into stock only for his sale. So you don't want to miss it. All right, you guys. Remember, follow me on Instagram, xi_missy_xi. I hope you guys have a beautiful weekend. Please take care. Love you.